Hi folks, hope you're all well. As regards vaping tools, I'm a long-term fan of the machine. But browsing around the DMT Nexus forums one day, I came across a new method using a type of electronic vaping machine. And it's called the Direct Emesh, or the Shanty Vape, after one of the Nexus members that put a lot of work into it. And being hailed as a revolution in cost-effectiveness and efficiency. And to be honest, if half of what's being said about this is true, then I'm wondering why it isn't more commonly being spoken about. So I'll include the link for that thread in the description. Now, I've looked into this method. It's still in the early days, but so far I've found that pretty much everything that's being said about on the Nexus post are true. And in fact, there are other advantages to it that haven't been mentioned there. So what I'll try and do in this video is show you the basics of how it all works, and hopefully we can get this method out to a wider audience. First thing we'll need for this then is a vape mod box. And you can think of this as a vape machine body without any heating coils or mouthpiece. And its job is just to supply microprocessor control power via a fairly comprehensive menu, supplies power to these terminals here. The inner one being positive and the outer being negative, so I believe. And this particular one runs off an 18650 battery, which screws in the bottom there. I picked this up for, I think it was about £38 from eBay, and that included a battery. Next thing we'll need is a mesh RDA, and this one's a Vandy Vape. You can get these for £15 to £20 from eBay. An RDA stands for Rebuildable Drippable Atomizer, but it's really just a posh name for something which enables you to connect power from the vape mod box to your own heating coils and heating elements that you yourself can design. In fact, this thing is actually designed to screw on the top of here. So if this is supplying the power, you can almost think of this as the light bulb, almost. So we just screw that on, like so. Now that we've got the RDA screwed onto the modbox body, it makes it a lot easier to dismantle the RDA, and which is what I'll do now. So if I grab the top bit of the RDA, just give it a long and gentle pull, off it comes. So now we've got the top bit removed, the base of the RDA, which is this, still screwed onto the mod box. And if we turn that around, we can see the two slots in there, which is where the electricity is delivered, and those slots will accommodate the mesh that we're about to cut for the heating element. We can make our mesh elements out of all sorts of different metals and alloys of metals, but the one that we'll be using for this is stainless steel grade SS316L, which just identifies the composition and the exact alloy of this particular type of stainless steel. Now, as you can see, I've got a roll of this. This came in at about £6 from eBay, but with the Vandy Vape mesh RDA, you do get a few small pieces of mesh with it, and these are of the correct material. This is the bag that it came out of. So we'll demonstrate using this. These pieces of mesh have to be cut to size and bent to shape, and the shape we're aiming for is a flat mushroom shape. This is one that I'm taking out. I'm not entirely happy with it, it's a bit ropey, but it does give you an idea of the kind of like rough shape. And I can show you how that fits into the RDA slots. Let me get this here, put him in, if it'll go in. Yeah, kind of like that. And then the screws are tightened, it even comes with a little screwdriver just to hold it in place. It tightens up the terminals on it. And then the spice itself is loaded onto the top of here. So here we have our bent bit of mesh. It's not perfect, but we'll give it a try. Yeah, and that fits. So yeah, anyway, the mesh coil is now fitted, and the first thing that it says to do is put it on a high wattage setting, which I put on 36 watts, and just burn the mesh to burn off the residues. And there we go. So, yep, that's looking good. So to do the actual vaping, we set this thing to temperature control mode. Again, you don't really have to know the science behind all of this if you just follow the procedures on the Nexus. But if you are interested, then what we have to do is set the required temperature to round about the 200 degree mark. I found about 205 to be about right. I have to set the material to stainless steel, which is, there's there, this SS. That's TCSS, is temperature controlled in stainless steel mode. And in temperature controlled mode, the modbox needs to know the element temperature because it tries to regulate the desired temperature under all conditions, whether it's a, you know, a really hard puff or no puff at all. For example, if you're taking a hard puff, then the airflow cools the element and the mod responds by increasing power to it. Now, the modbox can't tell directly how hot the element is, but it can work it out from an approximation by a continuous measurement of the electrical resistance of the mesh element. The way it does this is most metals increase the resistance with temperature in a predictable manner, and each material has its own temperature against resistance graph, which is called the temperature coefficient of resistance. So as long as the material type is programmed in and a reference taken at room temperature, then this temperature approximation is quite doable and is actually key to temperature controlled modes of operation on the mod. So yeah. The loading of the spice can be a tricky thing. I found the best thing is to use a folded bit of paper with the spice down there in the middle and just gently brush it on in little bits onto the element. Every 15 milligrams or so, just give the button a quick press just to melt the powder into like a buttery mess on the element. You won't need many top-ups of 15 milligrams, I assure you. So we've loaded the spice. It's time to reassemble the RDA, which is basically just put the lid on it. Like so. There we go. Take out this default mouthpiece. Place in the little adapter. And then this is where our long last drip tip comes in. And this was £5 from eBay. Wonderful little thing. Insert him. And there we have it. We're all ready to go. We just have one quick press of the machine to make sure it's in the right mode, and it is. Temperature control stainless steel, 204 degrees centigrade. And then we're all ready to go, which is just a case of putting the steel lips, pressing the button, breathing in for 10 seconds, holding it, and believe me, you'll be away. So, what's this like to use? When inhaling, there's almost zero taste. There's almost no smell either, and it certainly is not harsh in the least bit. It's extremely easy to inhale a huge dose in one toke, with none of the usual discomfort telltale signs that you're used to. On my first go, I was absolutely convinced that the element wasn't heating up, and at the end I was looking at the display on the mod box, trying to figure out what was wrong with it. It's really important to start off with a small quantity and work up. And also I found that pure white crystals from the Gordotech extraction to be vastly more powerful than the yellow stuff from a typical ATB extraction. I tried 20 milligrams of yellow and it was about right. It was still quite powerful, but right. A bit later I tried the same weight of pure white crystals, and it was one of these trips that I was wondering whether I'd overdone it. It just got absolutely insane. Now, another thing with this is only one toke is used, meaning that whilst you're holding it in, you typically have got a few seconds to put the vape mod down, lie down in comfort, press play on your music or whatever else you want to do while the effects are coming on strong. So there's no messing around with a hot oil pipe or a lighter or anything like that. You've just got a couple of seconds just to make yourself comfortable. So far, I mean, I've only had a quick go of this, about three goes in as many nights, but I've had a cleaner experience from all of these. As I say, it is early days, but it's almost like you're tuned in to an FM station when you're used to an old medium wave station. Everything just seems more crisp and sharp and clean, and it is generally a much, much nicer experience. Now, I don't know if that's going to last, but it's been really intriguing. It would be far easier to use outside if you ever wanted to than if you were using an open flame device. I don't really intend to do that myself, but some people might do. And it would be ideal for a newbie as well, as long as he could be persuaded to start off small and be very careful. This is so important. And there's almost no technique to master once the device is set up. Just take a deep breath, 10 seconds, hold it for, you know, for as long as you can, at least 20 seconds, blow out, and you're gone, mate. And it's also, as I said before, it's just super efficient with spice. Your spice going to last an awful lot longer. Now, one last thing I'll mention is it's, if you're a breakthrough merchant, this is the ideal device. It will just, it will blow your mind. It's just unbelievable the way it just gets a huge dose down without any discomfort and without you even realising it, really. So are there any disadvantages that I've found? Well, obviously it's going to be more expensive than a homemade machine or an oil pipe for a few dollars. I think the whole setup was around about £60. As we've seen, loading and is tricky. The folding of the element is also a bit of a pain, but the element will last many, many tokes. Another disadvantage with this is you can't use it for several trips consecutively without reloading. So every time you press the button and hold it and you breathe it for 10 seconds, there'll be absolutely nothing left if you've got the temperature right. And okay, as I said before, it is very easy to go too far if you're not really, really careful. I mean, this is what happened to me the other night. It was just insane. I couldn't believe it from just 20 milligrams. It was unbelievable. But overall, I am extremely impressed. I mean, the spices are going to last a lot longer. And I just can't understand why people aren't shouting this from the rooftops. So, yeah. Anyway, hope you found the video of interest, folks. Maximum respect to you. Thanks for listening, and I'll catch you very shortly. Bye-bye.